This personal item worn and signed by the Notorious B.I.G. recently sold for over $500,000 at the first hip-hop memorabilia auction. Was it a belt, a plastic crown, a watch, or a hat?
B.
He's saying B. He is absolutely correct. The plastic crown that, you know, is iconic now that Biggie wore in that iconic photo. Do you have any interesting Biggie memories or anecdotes?
My memories of Biggie, I had two little short stories that, and both of them I dropped the ball. Well, one of them I dropped the ball. The second one was, anyway, the first one was we were in Virginia. So I was doing a party for this dude and he brought Biggie down to host the party. Probably like right after Ready to Die came out. I talked to the promoter beforehand and told him to ask Biggie if it's cool if I bring my four track and a mic and had a beat already programmed in the four track so he could do a freestyle for my tape. And Biggie said, absolutely, no problem. Came to the booth when he was leaving the party. I'm still DJing for like maybe another hour. He whispered to my, he said, hey, my room is such and such. Come there after the joint so we could knock that out. I was like, all right, cool. And then, you know, these started kicking in. I get to the room. I call him. He says, give me an hour. I guess he was messing around with some chicks.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, I wake up, it's like 10 in the morning. I fell out.
So
drop, and then he was already gone.
No.
He was already gone. The second time, he was on his way to do my tape when they had that party where he broke his leg. He was on his way to do my tape.
Oh, wow.
They were coming across the bridge to come to the studio that I used to book time at, which is around the corner from D&D Studio called Noise in the Attic. I used to do all my tapes. That's where everybody came to rhyme on my tapes. And I didn't believe C's when he told me because I'm like waiting and waiting and waiting. And C's was like, yo, we had an accident. I was like, all right, C's, you know. But then I see it in the paper the next day. But, you know, that part never came out. Like, you know, it was not a big deal, I guess, you know, to where we were going. But they were coming across the bridge to come to the studio.